If you could be any animal in the world, what would it be? And why? If you're looking for some inspiration, the Boreal Forest has some pretty amazing animals to choose from. The Boreal Forest, also known as the taiga, is the world's largest land biome. It's home to lots of animals, but not so many people. What do they know that we don't? This forest is a chilly place with long cold winters and short cool summers. So how is it that so many animals thrive here despite the harsh conditions? Let's meet some of them and learn about their unique adaptations that help them survive in this frosty environment. We're glad you're watching Socratica Kids. You know us for our smart fun videos, but did you know there's more to the Socratica Foundation website? You'll find courses, worksheets, games, and even educational souvenirs for your home or classroom. Visit socratica.org to hashtag learn more. We're starting strong with the gray wolf. The gray wolf is one of the top predators in the boreal forest. These majestic animals can weigh between 60 to 145 pounds or 27 to 66 kilograms and measure up to 5 feet or 1.5 meters from nose to tail. They have thick fur that comes in various colors like gray, white, black, or even reddish brown. This fur coat counts as at least 2 adaptations. It protects the wolf from the cold and can help them blend into their surroundings. Gray wolves live and hunt in packs, which are like close-knit families. A pack can have 5 to 15 members, including parents and their babies. Working together, they can hunt large prey like moose, deer, and caribou. Fun fact, gray wolves can travel up to 30 miles or 48 kilometers in a single day while patrolling their territory. Now let's meet another mammal on the smaller side, the snowshoe hare. These little critters only weigh about 3 to 4 pounds or 1.4 to 1.8 kilograms and measure 16 to 20 inches or 41 to 51 centimeters long. It takes its name from its large furry hind feet that act like snowshoes, helping it walk on top of deep snow without sinking. We saw how the wolf's coat sometimes helps it blend into its surroundings, but predators aren't the only animals who get to use camouflage. Snowshoe hare goes one step further. Its fur changes color with the seasons. In the summer, it's brown to blend in with the dirt. In the winter, it turns white to match the snow. This color change helps protect it from predators like wolves and owls. Snowshoe hares are mostly active at night, eating plants like grasses, leaves, and bark. You know who else is active at night? The great gray owl. The great gray owl is one of the largest owls in the world by length, standing up to 33 inches or 84 centimeters tall, with a wingspan of up to 5 feet or 1.5 meters. Despite their size, they are quite light, weighing only about 2.5 pounds or 1.1 kilograms. Must be all those fluffy feathers. These owls have big, round faces with yellow eyes and circles of feathers that aren't just for show. They help collect and funnel sound towards their ears to help them hear even the quietest rustling. Great gray owls usually hunt at dawn and dusk. One special talent that helps their hunting is the ability to turn their heads almost all the way around to look for predators and prey. They nest high up in trees, often using old nests from other large birds. Both parents take care of their chicks until they're ready to fly on their own. These big birds mostly eat small rodents, but they won't say no to a snowshoe hare, or a frog, or a snake, or a fish. Like other owls, they're known for their almost silent flight, which must come at a big surprise to their prey. Let's move from the skies down into the waters of the boreal forest. Aquatic animals live in this region too. The northern pike is a fierce fish found in lakes and rivers of the boreal forest. They can grow over 4 feet or 1.2 meters long and weigh up to 62 pounds or 28 kilograms. With their long torpedo-shaped bodies and sharp teeth, They're built for speed and hunting. Pike have greenish bodies with light spots that help them hide among the underwater plants. They are ambush predators, which means they hide and wait for prey like smaller fish, frogs, and even ducklings to come close before striking quickly. Northern pike can sometimes eat prey that's almost half their own size. That's like eating a sandwich the size of our legs. Holy cow! In the spring, female pike lay thousands of eggs in shallow waters. The eggs hatch in about 2 weeks. Then the little fish are on their own. Good luck to you, fierce little fishies. You've definitely heard of wood, and you probably know what frogs are, but have you ever heard of the wood frog? The wood frog is a small amphibian, about 2 to 3 inches or 5 to 7.5 centimeters long. It has a brown or tan body with a distinctive dark mask across its eyes, making it look like a tiny superhero. What's truly amazing about the wood frog is its ability to freeze into a frogsicle during the winter. As temperatures drop, it produces a natural antifreeze that protects the inside of its cells. The frog's abdomen fills with ice surrounding its organs, and ice forms in the spaces between the cells. Its heart stops beating and the frog stops breathing, but when spring arrives, it thaws out and comes back to life. Wood frogs breed in early spring in ponds created by melting snow. The female frogs lay eggs in the water, which hatch into tadpoles. Tadpoles have gills and live in the water, but not for long. These tadpoles grow quickly, so they can become frogs before the ponds dry up. Frogs have lungs, like us, so they can breathe air. Pretty nifty trick. I mean, adaptation. Moving on to an animal that slithers, the common European adder is a snake that can live in the cooler climates of the boreal forest. It grows up to 32 inches or 80 centimeters long and has a zigzag pattern along its back, which can be gray, brown, or reddish. Adders are venomous, but their bites are usually not dangerous to humans. They're shy and prefer to avoid people. They eat small animals like mice, lizards, and frogs. Unlike many reptiles, adders give birth to live young instead of laying eggs, which helps the baby survive in colder temperatures. In case you want to talk about this with your friends, zoologists have two special words you can use: viviparous and oviparous. Viviparous means an animal gives birth to live young. The viv part means alive. Think survive, vivacious, and viva Las Vegas. Oviparous means an animal lays eggs instead. Ovi means eggs. This is where we get the word oval, which means egg-shaped. What do you think so far? Could you see yourself living in the boreal forest with the owls and the wolves and the trees and the snow? We do have a video all about this biome as part of our biome series. So when we say biome, we don't just mean the environment or the animals, but everything. Who lives there? What is the climate like? The whole shebang. We'll link the series below. Some creatures of the boreal forest are very small. The spruce bark beetle is a tiny insect, about 0.25 inches or 6 millimeters long, but it plays a big role in the boreal forest. It has a hard shell and lives under the bark of spruce trees. These beetles help break down dead trees, which returns nutrients to the soil. However, if there are too many beetles, they can harm living trees by eating the inner bark, which can kill the tree. Unfortunately, outbreaks of spruce bark beetles can lead to large areas of dead trees, which can increase the risk of forest fires. Yikes! Luckily, here's an animal that helps keep the population of spruce bark beetles in check: the squirrel. More specifically, the red squirrel, which is a small, lively rodent that weighs around 7 to 10 ounces or 200 to 280 grams and measures 11 to 14 inches or 28 to 36 centimeters long, including its bushy tail. It has reddish fur with a white belly and tufted ears, especially noticeable in the winter. Other than beetles and other insects, these squirrels also eat seeds from pine cones, nuts, berries, and sometimes bird eggs. Red squirrels are known for collecting and storing food in secret caches to help them survive the winter. Do you think they remember where all their hiding spaces are? From the very fast to the very slow, here's another one of the smaller animals of the boreal forest, the red slug. The red slug is a soft-bodied creature found in moist parts of the boreal forest. It can grow up to 6 inches or 15 centimeters long and is usually reddish-brown, which helps it blend in with fallen leaves. Red slugs are decomposers, meaning they eat dead plants and help break them down into soil. This is important for recycling nutrients in the forest. They are mostly active at night to avoid predators and drying out. That's right, slugs have to stay moist all the time. That may help you remember that they're mollusks and are related to aquatic animals like clams and oysters. But they don't have a protective shell, and they move extremely slowly. So they're easy pickings for snakes, toads, birds. They have a lot of natural enemies. Not all invertebrates are prey. Some of them act as predators, like our next little boreal forest resident. Lynx spiders are small spiders, about a half inch or 1.2 centimeters long, with long legs covered in spines. They are often green or brown, which helps them hide among leaves and branches. Unlike many spiders, lynx spiders don't build webs. Instead, they hunt by jumping onto their prey, like tiny insects. They have excellent eyesight and are very quick. Lynx spiders actually get their name because they're such agile hunters, just like the lynx, a cat who also lives and hunts in the boreal forest. The lynx is a wild cat who is perfectly suited for life in the boreal forest. It has long legs and large furry paws that act like natural snowshoes, helping it walk on top of deep snow. The lynx is known for its short, dark tail and distinctive tufts of black hair on the tips of its ears. With thick, silvery brown fur that keeps it warm in freezing temperatures, the lynx is a solitary and mostly nocturnal predator. You probably know what your cat likes to eat. Cat food. But what about wild cats like the lynx? Oh, you name it. If it's smaller than the lynx, it's probably on the menu. Snowshoe hares and other small mammals, birds, fish, even carrion. That's the scientific name for things that are already dead. But you might be surprised to hear the lynx will even stalk and bring down animals that are bigger than itself, like deer and caribou. Now, here's one animal too big for a lynx to hunt, the moose. The moose is the largest member of the deer family. Male moose, called bulls, can stand up to 6.5 feet or 2 meters tall and weigh over 1,500 pounds or 680 kilograms. They have long legs for walking through deep snow and wetlands, a hump on their shoulders, and a droopy nose. Male moose grow huge antlers each year, which can spread up to 6 feet or 1.8 meters across. Even when they're first born, moose are pretty impressive. They weigh about 30 pounds and can stand up and walk on their own that very first day of their life. That doesn't mean they fend for themselves, though. Moose moms keep a close eye on their babies and keep them hidden from predators. But they grow up quickly, following their mothers and learning how to eat a variety of boreal forest plants. Moose are herbivores, eating leaves, twigs, and aquatic plants. They're excellent swimmers and often wade into water to eat plants growing there. Despite their size, moose can run up to 35 miles per hour or 56 kilometers per hour. What are they running from? There isn't much a full-grown moose has to worry about. Those big gray wolves we met earlier are one of the few animals that hunt the moose. Grizzly bears too. But for the most part, the moose can walk around the boreal forest like he owns the place. If you could be any animal in the world, would it be one from the boreal forest? From the powerful gray wolf to the tiny wood frog that can freeze itself for safekeeping over the winter, there are so many impressive and beautiful animals that each play an important role in this biome. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.